Hello, and welcome to Sunday's Sermon. I'm Elder George Lockhart of the Church of the Living God, the pillar and ground of the truth. Today's lesson, Teach the Children. Our text is taken out of 2 Kings 2, 23 through 25. You know, children love to learn. They just hate to be taught. Teaching is a discipline. When you go to college, they say, what is your discipline or what is your major? Often we discipline our children or we teach them a lesson. The Bible is full of scriptures that talks about how to corral your children and teach them. Exodus 20 and 12 says, honor thy father and thy mother, that thy days may be long upon the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. Proverbs 4 and 1 says, hear, ye children, the instruction of your father, and tend to know understanding. Proverbs 14 and 26, in the fear of the Lord is strong confidence, and his children shall have a place of refuge. Proverbs 17 and 6. Children's children are the crown of old men, and the glory of children are their fathers. Proverbs 19 and 18. Chasten thou, son, while there is hope, and let not thy soul spare for his crying. Why would a child be crying if you chasten him? In today's society, we understand if you whip your children or if you spank them, you may have a great chance of having Children Family Services visit your home. You may go to jail. But what does the Bible say? Proverbs 20:11 says, even a child is known by his doings, whether his work is pure and whether it be right. Here's one, Proverbs 22:6. Train up a child in the way that he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. 22:15, foolishness is bound in the heart of a child, but the rod of correction shall drive it far from him. There it is again, the rod of correction. Should it be words? Should it be punishment? What does the Bible say? Maybe we should look at 23 and 13, Proverbs. Withhold not correction from the child, for if thou beatest him with a rod, he shall not die. That's very interesting on how we should chastise our children. I'm not saying that you should beat them bloody, give them a whipping. What I am saying is the Bible speaks. You either believe in the Bible or not. They will grow up and tell you later on how you have deployed your chastisement. My grandmother used to say, when the children are little, they worry your knees, but when they grow up around your heart, they worry your heart. Now to the lesson. In today's story, we talk about Elisha. Elisha, whose name in Hebrew means God is salvation. Remember, the word El in the Jewish text means God. Joel, Beth-El, Michael. He was an Israelite prophet and a disciple of Elijah. Elijah is described as the son who came from a rich family. Elijah preached and worked in the northern kingdom of Israel and eventually came to live on Mount Carmel with a servant. Elijah is depicted as a miracle worker, for example, healing the sick and reviving the dead. One curious story has him calling out two bears to maul and kill a group of children who mocked his bald head. Today is what we will discuss. It should be noted that the word children here, it would not be talking 8 or 10-year-old children. Probably they were teenagers. The word children was used of Joseph when he was 28 years old, so it's probably a mistranslation. But these weren't children, they were tough boys. They had him surrounded. How do we know that? It says that he had a bald head. That means that he was bald from the back, most likely. Juvenile delinquents were coming in to mock him and on the way into their city. And so they were really bothering and probably meant to do Elijah harm. You know, when they say go up, bald head, go up. Elijah, his predecessor, had already gone up to heaven. They were telling Elisha to go up to heaven also. Leave us here because they wish him to die. The Bible is very clear about messing with God's elect. Psalms 105:15 says, touch not mine anointed and do my prophets no harm. You think God was joking? Two she-bears came out of the woods. Why they were she-bears, not sure. But they came out and they mauled the children. These children, where were their parents? 42 of them? On another occasion, Job talks about how he was somebody before he was cursed by the devil with God's permission. When the young people saw him, they would flee and run when he walked into the city, how they would cover their mouths. But under his affliction, he says, the young people now insult me, although their fathers would have been a disgrace to be my sheepdogs. And those who insult me are helpless themselves, their children. He says how their only homes are ditches and holes between rocks, where they bray like donkeys and gather around shrubs. Job 30th chapter is very clear, and the 9th verse really says it all. Those worthless nobodies make up jokes and songs to disgrace me. They are hateful, and they keep their distance even while they're spitting in my direction. Where are the parents? Another occasion, woe unto them that are with child in the last days, and to them that give suck in those days. But pray that your flight be not in the winter, neither on the Sabbath day. Then shall be great tribulation, such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time, nor ever shall be. In other words, women, you better hope during the last days that you don't have to deal with your children or pregnant, because raising a child takes a lot of work. Ephesians 6 and 4 says this, "Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy father and thy mother, which is the first commandment with promise, that it may be well with thee, and thou mayest live long on the earth." That ends today's lesson. I hope you've learned something about what does it take to teach a child. Parents, before you have the responsibility of creating a child, make sure you know the rules. And always remember, God is in control.